money. I know what I'm saying to you is right, okay? And he said, there's no way I could make this up or even know this, because you don't even know it, okay? And this is going to be your proof positive. I understand, I have the Virgo ascendant, we need proof positive, okay? That it's your son, that Dustin came through, that he's fabulous, that he's, you know, the welcoming committee extraordinaire up there, and that he's with you 24/7, that it's him brushing your cheek. And this guy, Michael, all right, I hear Michael row the boat ashore. Michael is going to be the one to say something to you about guitar or guitar lessons, or he's a guitar teacher, music teacher, something to do with your son, all right? And it's going to blow you away when it happens, because, bing, your memory chip, because you forget nothing, is going to click in, all right? And you're going to say, you know what, maybe that woman isn't so nuts after all.
No, I don't think you know.
Okay, good. God bless you. Thank you for
thank you for coming.
Especially, I mean, that's something, a mother losing a child. God bless you, baby. You've been, give yourself credit. You know the kind of strength that you have.
It's hard.
That's why he was saying he's so proud of you.
Yeah.
Because each and every day you get up and you get out of bed and you're making him proud because you had to continue. You know, and don't stop talking to him because he hears you all the time.
Yeah, he loves the conversations.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
God bless you. Thank you, honey. And it's, you know, it's like situations like this, Robert, that really make me aware, and I'm sure maybe you too, that this is why we're doing the work.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when you can almost like proof positive, allow someone to open up their heart again. And because of all that trauma and loss, and so many people build up those layers in front of their heart chakra, you know, and I think they come through like that to, boom, kind of like open it up again and say, hey, I love you, I'm with you, you know, life is still beautiful, and I'm still with you, maybe just not physically, but you can still feel me caressing your cheek or, you know, the whole nine yards.
I agree.
And hopefully we can help this lovely lady. Yeah. Hello, Barbara.
Hello, Gracie.
Scorpio, you. I call it Babs. Okay. All right, Barbara. So
after that one, how do you follow?
Well, that's what's so great about spirit is that, as Robert was sharing with me before, when he's working, it just it's like building up momentum. Mm-hmm. You know, instead of I think I can, it's I know I can. Mm-hmm. All right. And and you've you're another individual who's dealt with, had to deal with a lot of loss, right? And but it's your brother who's here front and center.
Oh,
okay.
Good.
Yeah. And he says the cowardly lion. Okay. Please don't think of him as the cowardly lion because he took his life. Okay. It's, you know, it's tough. Now, do you know, was your brother bipolar? Was there some sort of
possibly
something that was not right with his body chemistry? Okay. He's showing me that even though he was married, he really wasn't sorry about leaving her.
No, I know.
Okay. And I have to be truthful, okay? But it's you two have kind of like Siamese, if you please. Siamese, if you don't please. It's like you two are very connected, very close. And aren't you feeling that?
Oh, I feel it completely. When I was watching you sitting down, I could see him right behind you. And he also is saying thank you for trying all the time to build him up and bring him up.
Yeah.
You didn't fail him. You do know that. You know? And the peace that I find in his soul is tremendous. The marriage, on the other hand, was very stressful to him. There was no, without disrespecting the wife, mm-hmm. there was never a moment of being able to make her happy. You know, even after he crossed over, it was always about her. You know, it wasn't even about the loss of your brother or your family. It was about her. But he does call you someone in this lifetime who we treasured.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
You know, and it's interesting when I read into him, if I would have met him and I wasn't intuitive or psychic, I never would have known how deep his depression was, because He had that ability to mask it.
He laughed all the time.
He did. You know, certain people, sad to say, you could look at them and you could recognize that they're going to, sad to say, cross over. You never would have seen that in him. It just got to the point that it was just enough. Mm. Enough. And do I find peace in his soul? I do. But he's also very sorry for the damage that the death has left. Mm. You know? And the other thing I was going to say, you won't find them at a cemetery. If you anywhere, go to a park or the ocean. You know, but I do see him as being free. He has children. Try not to allow the wife to get in your way. Okay, because he wants you to fight for them. She's a very, and again, I'm not trying to disrespect her, but she's very self-centered. It's always about her, even with the kids.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
very much so.
It seems like she's trying to push the people that truly loved your brother away.
Yeah, she wants nothing to do with us.
Yeah, you know, so if it's possible to forge a relationship with the children, try your best. Mm-hmm. But I will tell you, she's going to block you on every obstacle.
Yeah.
You know, but from the soul of your lost brother, I find peace and joy. You know, I got to say...
Are they all up there?
They're always up there, you know.
Is he with my parents and my sister?
The word I was getting from him is like, you're the last one standing. Do you still have siblings that are alive?
Two.
You know, it's just that if you were ever to write a book, okay, with the journey that you've had in this lifetime, the title would be, I'm Still Standing.
Or, I get knocked down, I get up again. Right? Absolutely.
You got no choice.
Yeah, well, you know, you keep on keeping on. When you walk through the storm, keep your head up high and don't be afraid of the dawn. That's a beautiful song from Exodus. And just so true, because you have the strength of a Scorpio. You know, anybody else would have had a nervous breakdown, Barbara. So your brother's saying thank you for being the shoulder to lean on. Thank you for always being the loving, nurturing soul that you've always been. And he's thanking you for making a way when no way seems possible to stay in contact with the kids. He's got two kids, right? Three?
Four. Well, together four. He's got one from her first marriage, three with her.
I only see two that you're going to be able... Are there only two that you're in contact with now?
One.
There's going to be two that you're going
to
be...
I'm hoping the oldest one is going to try to
He says that there are going to be two that you're going to be able to still connect with.
Okay.
All right? And he says, and that's good enough.
Okay.
He says, so don't beat yourself up for, you know, oh, I should, you know, be saving them all. Okay? Everybody, every soul has their own karmic reason that they choose to be where they are for their own growth. Okay, but for the two that you will be in contact with, it's just meant to be that you resonate your brother's love energy for them. Okay, and he says, you know, he says it's a lot different than he imagined it would be.
It sure is.
You know, and you know, he used to make jokes about it. Okay, a lot. He said, right?
Always.
And he said, but. He's not a zombie like he thought he was going to be. Did he used to make jokes about that?
We all did.
Yeah, really? Oh, okay. Okay, so he's being like really flippant and irreverent right now.
That's him.
Okay, all right. So I'm just cleaning it up because we're on TV. I mean, we're on the internet. We're Mike Peters has a streaming live. Okay, so stream a little stream with me. He's just... He wants you to know it's authentic. It's really him, but you already know that. Okay? And he says he's going to leave you a present. And I keep seeing a Gerber daisy, which is wild. But it's like almost, it's a rich color. A Gerber daisy that's almost like an autumn color. Right? So let me just give you that message. And also that there's something to do with his furniture. Is she selling his furniture on eBay?
Oh, I don't know. She could be doing anything at this point.
He says, don't worry about his furniture. So maybe someday somebody says, you know, I was going through eBay the other day and I saw something that looked like your brother's or blah, blah, blah. Don't let it fire you up. He said, she always tries to press your buttons and don't let her do it anymore, he said.
Okay.
You know, finito. Morta, no more. Mm-hmm. Okay? And also, your mom is saying that don't think that she's abandoned you. She hasn't. All right? And she says, you always felt that it was almost like you guys didn't say it to each other. It was like looks. Did you and your mom didn't really talk to each other? You just looked at each other?
But we kind of knew what we were about. Yeah.
Right? Is that true? All right. I just want to make sure that's what she's communicating to me. And she says now she can find the mouthpiece, which I guess is me, to let you know how much she loves you and how beautiful you are and how grateful and how proud she is that you're her daughter. Okay? And she wishes she was able to say that when she was here in the physical. She said she was too stubborn, though. Is your mom a little on the stubborn side? You know, like stubborn, mm-hmm. like, well, I don't have to say this. It should be known. She knows. You know what I mean? But you're hearing it now. There you go. She says the proof that she's saying this to you is going to come within 3 weeks. That there's something going on with a fire alarm or a battery in a fire detector, smoke detector, at your house. And she says, it's her.
Okay. I'll look forward to that.
Woohoo! All right. And you got anything else for her?
What I was going to say, out of your two siblings, who's the temperamental one?
The one that's closest to me in age.
Yeah, because what your brother is saying, the two of you, you and your brother just used to listen to that one and just roll eyes.
Well, Diane just was Diane.
Roll
just
eyes.
Let her go.
You know, she would just start going. There was no stopping her. Reminds me of like the cartoon of Tasmanian Devil. She just goes in circles.
She got her way, yeah.
Yeah. And what I want to say is good luck with that relationship because she holds on to resentment. She needs to learn how to just let things go. You know, and I am sorry for the loss of your brother because the love coming from him was tremendous. You know, good luck with his children, though.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Barbara.
Thank you.
Thank you, honey. And I'm so grateful to people that find the courage, especially, and they have to realize that other people are helped as they're being assisted, too. You know, how many people will be watching and saying, you know, I went through the same experience with my sibling. Or my parent, or whatever, and it resonates with them, and they get the aha moment.
It's true,
you
it's
know.
True. We're all taught valuable lessons in order to help other people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it just takes a very strong person to go through what these people are going through. So you know, they need to sit back and recognize that they're a lot stronger than they even anticipated.
Yeah, and so we're here to salute all the strength and all the beautiful souls that we have here tonight and out there watching. And if you want to be here live and personal, email me with your name and your digits, and we'll make it happen for you so you too can feel the love. And Robert, again, thank you so much. Again, RobertRichardWright.com. We love you.
Well, thank you for having me here.
Seriously.
Thank you.
Thank you.